asan yung pera ko? Ganyan. Ibalik niyo yung ganito. And we were like so dumbfounded. Like,
that was Kat, the marketing director from Smart Trade, a training and consultation company which provides free training to Filipinos who want to start trading foreign currencies and commodities. Smart Trade is legit, one of the resources you would tap if you want to learn how to start trading.
So we offer free learning sessions on how to trade the forex market, CFDs, oil, gold, and any trading assets, no. So aside from that, kinokontakt naming free learning session. We offer one-on-one coaching. We offer seminars. We offer free webinars and different trading courses.
You walk them through how to use the platform and also how to identify potential trades. Like, oh, I think undervalued yung rupee ngayon. Parang ganon. What are the contents of the ano of the training?
Yes, training namin, no. So of course, nagsisimula kami sa introduction muna about the forex trading, you know, the ins and outs. And then after that, followed by the navigation of the platform. So once na natin na nila yung mga basic trainings na yan, so from there, may na-offer din kaming libreng advanced classes.
So why was it that they were getting complaints? We'll find out right after you hear about our sponsor, who I'm sure you will not have any complaints about.
Sawa ka na ba sa unactivated windows mo? Well, lucky you! Pinakabago mula sa cdkeyoffer.com. Windows 10 and Windows 11 activation codes. Legit, safe, at pinakamura. Madali lang umorder.
Hanapin ang Windows version na gusto mo. Piliin ang preferred paper and pencil. Wala pang 5 minutes, nag-CDK ka na para sa Windows mo.
Marami na kaming natulungan!
Dati, sad and depressed ako. But now, I found the love of my life!
Dati, aimless and walang purpose ang life ko. But now, I'm a world-class Zumba instructor!
So, web developer ako and content creator for a YouTube channel. And ngayon, ganun pa rin ako pero activated na yung Windows ko.
Kaya ako naghahanap ka ng legit, mura, at original software.
Check out cdkoffer.com.
Check out cdkoffer.com.
Check out cdkoffer.com.
So we just found out that there's this group that has been using our name. May Facebook page din sila. And meron din silang sponsored post. That means, nag-add sila just to trick lots of people.
As a business owner myself, having scammers use the good name of the business to con people is a nightmare. Pinaghirapan mo kasi yun. Like for Hardware Sugar, we put a lot of effort to show that even though we're a small one-branch PC shop na hindi kasing sikat ng other larger stores, that you can trust us, that we take care of our customers. All of that hard work and then a bad actor uses that goodwill attached to the name of a business, sayang lang.
They use our brand name and then they created a Facebook page, may ads, and then meron pang Facebook group na ginawa din sila.
Okay. So, and then how did they get money from people? So there was a fake Facebook group, there was a fake Facebook chat group ba? Sorry, there was also like a Facebook community using your brand name. And then how did they monetize that? How did they execute the scam?
What they do is just that one, they presented an investment. So as low as 500 pesos, you can already invest in online trading. So 500 pesos, and then your 500 pesos will turn into 700 pesos in 1 week.
Oh, so there's almost 50% return after 1 week.
Yes.
Ah, from 500 to 700. Oh, sino bang hindi may gusto nun?
Yes, everybody would like, oh, sige, ano yan, go yan, diba?
How similar is the fake Facebook page to your Facebook page? Like, ano yung pangalan nung totoo, tsaka ano yung pangalan nung peke?
Yung peke kasi, nakalagay lang talaga niya sa kanya smart train. Mm. With the same spelling, with the same... Different lang yung logo niya, like color green yung ginamit nila.
Instead of the blue, but I can see the blue in the background. So there was an effort put into this particular scam. Aside from establishing an online presence to mimic the legit brand, the scammers also had attention to detail to make the fake pages look like the real thing. And aside from the look of legitimacy, they also had the social validation of legitimacy. Fake comments were left saying that, yes, this investment is great, and people actually received the wild ROI that was being claimed.
I think true po sila. Because there are people din na nagko-comment na nakatanggap sila at totoo. May mga testimonials silang ganun. Yes.
Yeah.
That would add to the fuel so that people would really, you know...
Looks credible.
Totoo nga. Looks credible.
Yes. And as with most scams these days, the money was transferred online to a personal GCash account.
May CEO silang tinatawag na yun daw yung kumuha ng pera nila through GCash. So one, we're not sure if this is a real person behind it or this is also an identity theft.
Once SmartTrade gathered enough information, they did report the scammers. Remember our episode with the officer from the PNP Cybercrime Division? A lot of the initial burden is on the victim to gather enough information so that the authorities and or the platforms have enough to go on.
Well, upon our investigation, we'll see it's sponsored. We've already reported the ad.
To Facebook?
I think it's after... To Facebook, yes. To ads to Facebook. And then we've made two kinds of reports. One is for fraud because, you know, we've been receiving reports and we also have screen caps of it. And then secondly, we've also, aside from fraud, we've also for the IPO, for the identity.
Ironically, SmartTrade is all about financial education, which includes assessing whether offers like the scam offer are too good to be true.
Advice that we can give to people, one is always practice caution and due diligence. Diba? Think twice if the offer is too promising, if it's something more than that any bank can offer. Yon.
Yeah.
Yan, lagi na namin sinasabi yan sa mga learning sessions namin. Yes, totoo. Online trading. In online trading, in even in FX or in gold, in crypto, yes, you can earn. Even nag-uusap tayo ngayon ng ton. I entered the trade and I exited the trade. I might double my investment.
Yep.
But, pwede rin habang nag-usap tayo, matalo rin yun.
Yeah. Babagsak din yun.
It's just one click, and then one snap, one click.
Yep.
That's one thing that you also need, that every learner and every Filipino should know, that high risk and high reward ratio.
Yes, yes, yep.
Risk management.
And you know, education really works. Of the people scammed, none of them seem to have been former students of SmartTrade. They had not gone through the courses. A lot of them do not even seem to have been familiar with the brand. Na-entice lang talaga sila dun sa promised return on capital na ang taas. More knowledge, more repetition on what to look out for, those are really vital in protecting yourself against scammers.
Tinignan natin, is there anyone that already attended? Kasi yun ang pinagtataka namin, if ever someone has already attended our session here in the office or outside, even before pandemic.
Yes, diba? Yes.
So even before pandemic, kasi we go to different areas. Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, naiikot namin yan eh. We never had this on names.
Well, this was the first time that SmartTrade was enmeshed in a scam. It's not the first time they've observed it. Inevitably, as a financial educator, they have seen lots of kinds of scams.
May mga na-encounter kami from different parts of the Philippines. So, may mga na-encounter silang ganyan, yung hacking and phishing. Siguro, just to share, no? Yung pinaka-worst na narinig ko na ganyan is yung tinatawag nilang pump and dump schemes. So, ginagawa ng brokers, they artificially inflate the price.
Yeah.
And then, ang ginagawa is they they make some false information or rumors. So say, for example, sinabi nila tataas yung price ng isang currency pair, and then a lot of the clients will place buy position from there, and then once they inflate na yung price, they will sell the currency or the instrument. So from there, it will cause the price to plummet, and of course, maraming matatalo sa ano sa mga traders. Some of them, they've encountered yung, let's say, individual or maybe group of people na they have exaggerated claims of high profits, and aside from that, they also promise guaranteed profits, and worse is yung tinatawag na withdrawal restrictions. May mga ganyan cases na narinig ko. Like if they invest today, so may lock-in period na tinatawag na they cannot withdraw after X amount of months. But in reality kasi, you know, sa totoong mundo ng trading, they can withdraw anytime.
Yeah. I mean, if it's a legitimate platform, there shouldn't be any reason why di mo makuha yung funds mo kagad, di ba? There are types of people who are more likely to fall for scams, and knowing if you fit into that profile is also part of educating yourself.
When you talk about yung mga naloloko ng ganito, no, karamihan sa kanila yung mga medyo nasa borderline retirees na,
okay,
or yung mga retirees na, sila yung mga, actually wala kaming specific, no, but we have gathered some profiles nung mga people who get scammed, who get easily scammed, no. So first is yung age nga, because as you age, you become more vulnerable sa mga ganyan, or more people will try to get in touch with you because they know that kasi medyo ano ka na, medyo of age ka na. And then yung mga taong limited din yung kanilang due diligence na ginagawa. So ito yung mga taong basta-basta na lang they get into the bandwagon without knowing, kung without really trying to know. Narinig lang sa kapitbahay, narinig sa office mate,
okay, dito,
kasi ganito, sumama na rin. So sila yung mga taong, tapos yung mga masyadong nagre-rely sa online information, sila din yung madalas na nai-scam. And yung may mga trust in authority figures, yung mga masyadong nagpapadala sa mga influencers natin, or yung mga tao na narinig lang yung isang personality na nagsalita na maganda dito or maganda doon, naniniwala ka agad. And then yung mga taong medyo isolated sila, or walang masyadong social support. So ito yung mga taong nasa malalayong lugar or hindi masyadong kabihasnan, so to speak, no, yung locality nila. That's why yung mga taong naririnig natin usually na nai-scam sa investment, not only forex investment but other forms of investment, kadalasan nasa Mindanao area. You seldom hear people from Manila or Metro Manila being scammed on this kind of investment scams. Mas madalas naririnig natin, at pag naririnig natin, they come in hordes sa lalong-lalo na sa Mindanao.
Yung nakakainis pa about scams involving legitimate financial activities like trading, people might be discouraged from pursuing them even though they are legitimate avenues of investment. In that case, you had actual money lost to the scammer and also potential money lost. What you could have earned if you had invested the money in trading or with a legit fund but didn't because you had already been burned by a scam. I was curious how Smart Trade went about encouraging people who had already been victims of scams.
Usually, we present it to the clients who have once fallen victims of scams sa Forex. We try to present the business as it is. So, ibig sabihin, we really present it as a trading business yung pinapasok nila. Kasi marami sa mga kliyente na na-scam or na who are being victimized sa Forex trading. Ang akala nila sa Forex trading is parang plug and play. So hindi nila iniisip, ang iniisip nila, they just sink in the money or they just invest the money and then wala na silang gagawin.
Parang
mag-aantay na lang sila ng ano. So yun yung tinuturo namin talaga sa mga kliyente, that there's going to be an active part from their end or active participation from their end na kailangan silang matutong mag-trade, kailangan nilang matutunan yung mga principles ng trading and everything else that you need to know about trading.
Clearly, the antidote is more of what you guys are doing, parang education, letting people know. Just like as a horror story, what's the highest amount that you heard na nawala nung isang, na-scam dun sa isang ano tao?
On the average, ang usual stories na naririnig natin, siguro nagre-range ng about $200 to $500. But it's not also unheard that people lost money sa scammers sa Forex ng millions din.
Millions
of dollars.
Of dollars?
Of dollars, yes. May mga ganyan din naman ng mga stories.
Wow. Na local, ah? I mean, like, you know, somebody from Mindanao,
yes,
or something.
Local,
millions,
yes,
of dollars
local.
Na ano. Grabe, ah?
Millions of dollars din ang nawala sa kanya.
And then, as mentioned before, yung natural response, nahihiya ka eh. Na aminin, na pupunta ka sa police, yeah, or something. And even if you nga, you go to the police, it's very hard for the police also to track that, to ano. Grabe, ah? So parang...
Lalo yung mga high-profile clients, no? So, sila yung mga usually ayaw maghabol. Mm-hmm.
As you know, I'm into trading as well, particularly crypto, and I think it's a viable way to increase your net worth as long as you can steer clear of the scams. And education is the best way to do that. SmartTrade is a great way to learn more, especially if you're looking to trade traditional fiat. Their contact information is in the text description of this episode. This is Tech Show But Friendly, Hardware Sugars Podcast. I'm your host, Anton, and we are produced by Nana Nadal.